Hello everyone, my name is Brian and welcome to the Smite request. It is going to be Bastet in Clash. And as I'm already mentioning to my team, we will need a lot of anti-healing. And I really mean a lot of anti-healing. Like, take anti-heal and then multiply it by a lot and then you have a lot of anti-heal. And that's what we need. Because look at the opponent's side. They have three healers. A Hercules who is like double a healer in his own for himself. And a Chiron for, well, the little bit of tiny healing he has on his passive. Can still heal. And he also can build lifesteal, which is very likely for any hunter to build. Although with so much healing on your team, you wonder if he really is going to get it. Okay, so that's going to be mandatory Brawler's Beast Stick for me. I'm going to get it after my boots because I feel like I need the mobility more than anything else. Nice block by the Sylvanas. I will just leap away. We'll take some damage. That was a weird three. That wall collision is so weird in Clash. Some walls just have a little bit of a wider collision than they appear to be. Which kind of sucks. So far, my three is not really on the mark yet. But to be fair, I haven't played Bastet in forever. So that should be fine. I'm going to max out my two first. You always want to max out your two first, or most of the times at least. Because it's just a lot of damage. Against healing, maybe it's not even the best choice. Because, well, they can heal during the bleed. So that means that they will have an opportunity to save themselves. And if you go for the 1 or the 3, that damage is instant. But the 2 is still the most damage I will be able to do. And I'm not too worried about the healing just yet. They do have a lot of it. But in the early game, it is not as strong as later in the game. Looks like Chuck will be plucked. I don't have any mana to really help him. So I'll just back off. I kind of wanted to ult. But I don't think it would have helped anyway. If I went for it. Let's just head back. Get my boots online. Get that power spike. That's a good amount of power. Actually, never mind. I thought I was able to finish it already. It is power. Let's just keep it at that. It's 10 additional power. I mean, the next one will be a good power spike. It is 30 additional power, more than doubling what I have currently. Looks like our Sylvanas will be... Oh, wow, that was actually a very good pull by the Sylvanas. And Agni died for it. This Sylvanas' pulls have been on point. He was able to grab me without a root. And he was able to pick off this Agni with that. I tried to go for the ult. Unfortunately, they didn't stick on the Sylvanas. Because I think I put my two on the Hercules as well as the Sylvanas. Not 100% sure. Or didn't I do it? Not sure. But anyway, he was able to just get away. Because all my cats didn't focus the same target. I wanted them to focus the Sylvanas because he was the lowest. But... eh, who knows? Maybe he would have survived anyway. He has healing. He had the Chang'an with him and the Hercules, so nice pickup on the Ra. It looks like Ra's struggling, which is good because one healer being down in experience and gold is way better than none at all. Let's just head back. Nothing really to farm. Let's go for the power spike I was mentioning. So yeah, my next item will be the Brawlers. After that, probably Jotuns. And very likely for me that the item after that is going to be Titan's Bane. Because I do have a good amount of frontline. Chang'an isn't unlikely to pick up Breastplate either. So they can get a lot of protections. And then I want to get my Titan's Bane online to make sure that I can deal with that. Nice ultimate by our Korkan, and that will be able to pick it up. And Hercules Driving Strike misses. Completely off the mark. Nice pull though. Nice boulder. Perry will deny that knockup, and my cats will be able to hunt down the Hercules. No, I overjumped it. Come on. Let's just lead back. Yes, the bleed will be enough. Kind of risky, because with that healing, he might not have died to it. But if I didn't lead back at that moment, I don't think I would have had another opportunity, because the timer was running out. And I didn't want to stay in that position. I feel like in the end, I probably could have. But that's fine. Turned out well. so far. We're doing pretty well for us. Especially our Kyron is pretty fat. He's been able to solo the rock a couple of times already. This, by the way, also a new skin. The... what is it called, actually? I'm not sure what it's called. The Voyage? The Voyage? Yeah, the Voyage skin. With the Bastet, the Robo... Robo... Robo skin? The Egypt... Robo skin? I don't know. I have no idea what it's called either. I don't have any mana though, so I can't really do anything. I wanted to back, but I have Wisps on me, so... better use my time to just clear these minions a little bit. I can't stick around. I stayed for a bit when I was low on mana for one reason only. To make sure that I have enough gold for rank 2 of the Brawlers. Because that gives you 10 penetration, which is pretty good. And 25 power. So bring me to a total of 80. Not bad. I feel like this is the moment where Bastet probably shines. She does a lot of damage once you have your 2 maxed out. Ross struggling 0 and 5. He's feeding our team. He's feeding our teammates. Great. Let's just grab it. I have most damage, so it's fine. And nobody else on my team is around to grab it. No, not the Wisps. No, that does nothing. Well, still a little bit more than 100 damage. Oh, the Ra's here. If the Ra wasn't there, I probably would have engaged onto the Chang'e. Just leap in onto her and use my bleed, which I'm doing to the Hercules at the moment. Doesn't do as much damage. Baiting him into the driving strike. If he was quick enough, that actually could have killed me or forced my fury, but yeah, I'm fine. Let's see if I can get away. Looks like Sylvanas doesn't go for the pull. I think he could have gotten it. He's been playing like a beast. Come on. No, I can't see. Doesn't look like... oh, nice pickup. Never mind, I want to say it doesn't look like anyone will die to it. Chang'e was able to survive against my cats though, but yeah, it's fine. I think every single one of us can... oh, that's not good. Let's see if we can provide some peel for our Kyron. It's not a lot though. Oh, Kyron, you should have run. I can't help you anymore. I can't. I tried. I tried to do some damage to their Kyron to discourage him from attacking, but... yeah, with Sylvanas by his side, he's not too worried. He had his ultimate. So if he gets a kill while in his ultimate, he will be able to do a lot. He's also doing the best on their team so far. He hasn't died yet. It's actually pretty good. Yeah, Yotes next. I need the cooldown reduction. I like to have cooldown reduction on my stat. Since you... why did I walk into that? since you well, have to rely on all your abilities, having some cooldown reduction is never a bad thing. I can go for the breastplates. I'm not a huge fan in this particular game. The main reason is they only have two physicals, which are the Herc and the Kyron. To be fair, they deal most of the damage, but when it comes to late game, Chang'e will deal a lot. I think I'm going for a Mantle of Discord. Not sure when though, but Mantle of Discord will provide me only 10% CDR, which isn't too much, but when I have Jotuns in addition, it's still pretty good. And it provides me protections on both sides. And when I get low on HP, I will have that CC immunity and the AoE stun. Just very good altogether. Looks like the entire team is here. I definitely need to use Purification Beads there to not get pushed by the Hercules. Otherwise, I'll just die. There's no way I'm getting out of that one. Not alive, at least. Or not by using just my Purification Beads as I get pulled. I don't think so, at least. Looks like Herc misses his 2, which is great. And, well, Kokorkana has an easy time holding the right lane on his own. He can just place that tornado, so he's pretty safe. Which is good, because that means that they don't have a lot of pressure on the other side. So we can just stay grouped together. They have a good team fight, though. Or, well, not so much that they have a very good team fight, because they don't have that many CCs. Depending on if Chang'e hits a good ultimate or not. But they have a lot of healing, so if they survive and regroup, they can heal up to full very, very quickly. I'm doing so much damage. Look at that basic attack damage. Come on. No, I missed my... no, I didn't. No, yes, I missed my 2 on the Ra. Otherwise, he would have been dead already. Oh, I can't chase it. If I hit my two, he actually would have died. But we get the tower, we get 4 kills. So that's very good for us. We can go for... What can we go for? Don't think we can go for Phoenix since the Hercules already respawned. He probably won't allow us to go for it. I need... Well, let's just grab the middle lane. My red buff has worn off again. I'll just grab it. I've been doing so much damage in this team fight. Let's just back off a little bit. If he stops me and I try to back in the middle continuously, then Apophis will just spawn and whoop my ass with his... Well, this is, I think it's like 1600 true damage or something like that. That's an insane amount of damage. I can survive it with 15 HP when I'm at full at least. Which I wasn't, I think. I don't know. Looks like Apophis has spawned though. But yeah, what do I think of Bastet? I feel like Bastet's actually very good. But I also feel like Bastet's probably kind of worthless when she's behind. If Bastet is behind, she doesn't do too much because she's almost solely focused onto play damage. Or just straight up damage. She used to be pretty good at split pushing, but since they removed the backdoor protections, it's not as easy to get the Phoenix, but you can still do it. Or towers or whatever, by using your ultimate to tank it. Let's see if we can do some damage to the Sylvanas. That's a lot of damage. Aww, look at my Puri being down for 2 seconds. That sucks. I spammed my Sanctuary to try and get it off before the Herc ultimate hit me, but that stun lasted just a little bit too long, so... Won't be able to survive that, but looks like they did get the Sylvanas, but we a little bit too many casualties. I can English on our side. Yeah, do I want to get it? I do have some protections at the moment. Let's just get the Dinesbane. Crusher. Nah, let's just get the Dinesbane. Two of them have protections. One Eye of the Witch and one Breastplate, and they can get more of it. As you can see here, I expect them to get more defenses. Maybe even the Ra. The Ra has been struggling against our Chiron. I've been quite fat. I mean, I'm 4-1. Pretty farmed. Level 16. To be fair, I feel like all the levels have been pretty even so far. Sometimes you see a way more of a deficit. So someone like level 13 at this stage, or someone that's already level 18 or higher. Not really so much. The enemy team is also keeping up very well when it comes to just straight up the farm. I was thinking about ulting there. She saw me cast it, but charge didn't take as much damage. The Hercules was close and was also afflicted by my bleed. So the cats would have just went for him, and I didn't want to go for that. Let's just go for the Ra instead. The Sanctuary will be a lot. Can the cats finish it? Nope. I think they died in the tower by the Karn, or he was able to body block it. If you body block the cats, they will swap targets, so to speak. Let's see if we can... Oh, Karn, you're so dead. Let's see if we can juke out. I don't want to die, I'm too young. I'm too robot. Let's see if we can grab someone here. Oh, that's fine. Let's see if we can go for the Karn. No, he got healed by the Sylvanas, so it won't be enough. Nice pull by the Sylvanas again, grabbing the Agni. He will be able to get out alive though. Ra has arrived. Not too worried though, the Ra's been not performing too well. Although, I am quite low on mana, so I can just poke him down a little bit. I can bait him. I don't have any mana, but I can bait him. Maybe my team can pick him up. They are heading this way, he can just see them, so... He's so persistent trying to stop me. Maybe that's enough. He's hit by the tornado. Ah, very close. Wasn't close enough. Very close was the Ra to die. I think he healed himself. Or the tornado... Well, I'm not sure if the tornado at this stage does the same amount of damage as the one from Kukulkan. I think it does, but... Not sure. That's fine, though. I have my Dinesbane. Next up, not sure what I want to get. Let's see. Ooh, look at that damage. Sweet, kitty cats got it this time. Oh, crap. Let's just use Sanctuary, avoiding the driving strike by doing so because I wasn't slowed anymore. Looks like I can't hit my leap, but at least I can use it again. I can't hit anything on the Sylvanas, and I do need to be a little bit careful. I mean, I know it's Sylvanas, but if he hits me with his abilities, I will still take a good amount of damage. Still need a little bit more gold. I forgot they changed the price. I want to get the Hydra's Lament. It provides me 10% CDR, which is pretty good. But also the additional damage I will get on basics. And with the mana buff, I'll have full cooldown reduction at the moment. Since the I think the mana buff provides 15% right now. So I should have a lot of cooldown. Or I should have maximum cooldown now. And once I lose my blue buff and I can get a Mantle of Discord, I'll still have full cooldown reduction because the 10% of the Mantle of Discord. But I tend to get it. I do think that's probably the best bet to go for. Just because they have a lot of sustain, I feel like it's better if I'm able to survive longer. Even though I don't have any healing, surviving... Oh, that was close. He has the Shield of Regrowth, so if he's able to use his... Or if he uses his 3, you can definitely catch up to me, even if I use my dash. Right, you will not survive this. Once I hit my 3, he was dead. He was just dead. I have so much damage with my abilities. Poor Ra. He's been really getting stomped by us. To be fair, I feel like the most immobile gods are just struggling against Bastet. Not only a couple I feel like can really deal with Bastet very well. Probably mostly the Anubis, depending on how he builds. And how much of my abilities I'm able to hit. Against the cats, Anubis is definitely the best one. Because he can just heal up on the cats. Late game, he will just heal more than the cats will deal damage. So, cats not as effective against him. Any mage with a high burst can really get rid of the cats pretty easily late game. That's why it's also quite important to be ahead or even as Bastet. Because if you're down, that means your cats will have less HP. And that will also mean that you won't have as much... Let's see if I get him. Oh, he got bodied. He couldn't move at all. I like that so much when that happens. Not when it happens to me, but when I am able to do it with Bastet. But yeah, a lot of immobile mages are very easy to kill with the cats. Decent damage. 474 damage with that leap. So much damage. That's also one of the reasons why I like to level it before the 3. Even though the 3 is very good at finishing, you don't get increased slow with the level progression. So I like to get the leap, because if you leap in, hit your 2, hit your hit a couple of basics, you will just straight up kill someone if you're a bit fat. And that's just because of the amount of damage it does, and when you hit an ability, your bleed will have more damage. Look at that damage. Look at that damage. He just got destroyed. Exactly what I was talking about. I didn't even hit my 3 on him because the Chang'an blocked it. That was nutty. But yeah, let's get the Mantle of Discord. I'll lose a little bit of damage for it because I sell the blue stone, but it's only 15 power. I have 190 to begin with, so that's very good. And it's definitely worth it to get that cooldown reduction for it. Let's see if he is in time, if he timed it correctly. A little bit too early, but he still got the buff. Let's just give it to him. I think I'm 5% down to full cooldown reduction. He has more use to it. He has 20% CDR. I think he had the Cronus Pendant. So with this, he will have 35 as well. So good amount of cooldown reduction. And it's better for him. He can use his abilities a little bit more. Kind of asking if we can do the middle. Looks like the Chug doesn't really want to, so I guess it's fine. They do have a good pair of ultimates to secure it, even though we have the Kukulkan. The Ra Snipe and the Chang'an ultimate are still a risk. If Chang'an can stun the Kukulkan... Ooh, Sylvanas all by his own. He didn't go the way I thought he would go, but he just went to my team. And he will fall down. Let's just leap back, avoid the boulder completely. No need for risking any free damage. When I can just go for the left side Phoenix, since nobody's here. Probably the best. That damage though. I actually just realized, or actually today I realized that the Phoenixes have different HPs depending on the game mode. I know, right? I didn't even know that. That's so bad. Let's see if I can gank someone here. Let's just use Cats. A little bit of a distraction. That leap does so much damage. No, let's... What? Does the Phoenix continue attacking you when you're in the air? That sucks. Look at that damage. 1600 fire beam. Phoenix OP, dude. Phoenix OP. But yeah, yeah, the Clash Phoenixes have 2500 HP. Most other Phoenixes have like 2000, and I think it was the Joust one that has 1500 HP. So a lot of difference in the Phoenix HPs. I can't understand why, since the Clash game is a little bit more faster paced, you'll have your items sooner, so the protections will be, or the HP will be a bit more sufficient. As well as the, well, of course, the words. Of course, the game mode is 5-on-5 and it's a pretty small map, only two Phoenixes as well. So having a little bit more HP on them makes sense. But it makes it a little bit more difficult to get it on your own, since I kind of wanted to get it on my own. I was able to get it, don't get me wrong, but it takes a little bit longer. It takes like 4 or 5 basics longer. Nice try by the Sylvanas. I had to leap away. If he pulls me, I probably would have died there or took a lot of damage. If Shang had her ultimate, I would have died. If she used it, of course. Just because I have my purification beads on cooldown. Don't think I could have been on time. Look at that damage. Go kitties. Oh, I used them too late. Whoa, they insta-died. Did you see that? One Ra Beam and one from the Chang'e. Oh, that HP. One. Might die. I might die as well. No, I tried to dodge it. And I missed my 3. It would not have been enough to kill the Chiron, but it would have helped my team a little bit. What way to split up. Looks like the left side, the Agni and the Chiron were kind of occupied by the Sylvanas. And so we were a man down on the right side. But that's my bad anyway. I went in a little bit too aggressive. It's fine though. Unfortunately enough, I did cost me my relics. My Fury will be up when I'm alive, so I'll have that kind of protection still going. Nice snipe by the Ra. That was actually a very nice snipe. I don't think he can hold this. I think he'll just die if he tries. Actually, he does a lot of damage to the Hercules. I don't think the Hercules has a lot of physical protection. Which is odd, since he's dealing with so many physical... I mean, all of physical damage is just so much. But if he gets a lot of protections, it doesn't really work that well against me anyway, since I have the Titan's Bane. Still works, don't get me wrong. I kind of want to go in, but it's a 2-on-5. 2-on-4, actually. Massive damage. Using my ultimate to kind of strike them down a little bit. Looks like we're not able to... Never mind. We are able to pick up the Chiron, who was kind of separated from his team. Even though I was able to do a lot of damage to Chang'e and Ra with my Leap 2 combo, they are able to heal up a lot. And that's what I meant with the healing comp. As long as they have the time to heal up, they will fight. They will win the team fights. But if they do something like that, like the Chang'e did, probably not. You need to be a little bit careful. Actually, they are so distracted, I can just get the right Phoenix. I don't have my cats, but I don't think I need them. Let's just heal up, make sure that I have enough health to do this. Because last time, the minions died before I was able to get the Phoenix. So I had to finish it off while they died. I got this. Free Phoenix. They won't be able to defend. They are distracted by my team. Kokogon died for it, but it's definitely worth it. We got that Phoenix. It looks like we get the left side Phoenix once more. Byron, that's not a good choice. I don't have mana for my 2, but I will be able to avoid his 1. Does he die? Yep, he does. So that's going to be it. Chang'e is the only one left alive to try and defend this. But it looks like they don't want to try and defend this. They surrendered. Doesn't really matter. I don't think Chang'e on her own could have defended. I probably would have just either used an ability and just walked away or stayed until I died. But... yeah, I think we would have won that. We had fire creeps on the right side. Did we? At least we had creeps. Look at that damage, that juicy damage. They don't even have that much of healing done, actually. The Chang'e has most healing with about 7,600. But yeah, I feel like probably if you look at the healing done, healing done in total, Hercules definitely wins. He gets so much healing from just regenning off of the damage we dealt when he has used his mitigate to wounds. And he has a lot of protections with his first couple of items. And with his shield regrowth, he's able to just be extremely fast. Same for Chang'e. I actually haven't tried it on Chang'e yet. I think it can work very, very well. Because movement speed is what Chang'e is all about. Since her passive allows her to move even quicker when using abilities. If you get it on Chang'e, you'll be very, very fast. And it is full cooldown reduction. Didn't really work out in this game though. As you can see on our builds, I went for the Brawlers for the healing reduction. Kokoko went for the Divine Rune. Chiron went for the Brawlers. Chark went for the Brawlers and the Pestilence. And had the Cursed Ankh. Wasn't upgraded yet though. If he had it upgraded, it would have been a 65% reduction on the healing. And the Agni had the Divine Rune as well. So Kokoko picked it up very, very early. I would have liked it early on the Agni more so though. Because Agni can get it on the enemy way easier than a Kokoken. Kokoken has more difficult abilities to hit. Agni can just use Noxious Fumes, and there's literally no way you can miss that on someone. And it instantly applies it, because it deals damage. But yeah, he has so much ranged damage, which has good AoEs. I feel like on Agni it's a lot better. Anyway, that's going to be it. Thank you so much for the request. I had a lot of fun. I've played 2 Bastet games and I forgot how strong she can be. But like I mentioned, she's pretty weak when she's behind. And that's the downside. Like I mentioned, she only has the split push potential. And since they removed the removal of backdoor protections by the cats, she won't be able to split push as effective as she could. But she's still very good at objectives in general. For instance, Gold Furies, Bull Demon King, etc, etc. Just because the cats can tank that for a bit, so you can get it quite early. Hope you guys enjoyed. If you have any other requests, please let me know down in the comments. And as always, good luck, have fun, and I'll see you guys in the next one.